24/7 News for the latest information relating to the Black experience. I'm Aaron Elkins, and here are today's headlines. Our top story, the 43-year-old father who made national news when he took it upon himself to confront his daughter's bullies is speaking out. James Jones was arrested and charged with disorderly conduct and disturbing a school function after this incident was captured on video.
My daughter's getting on this damn bus and a mother with her, and now this is
Jones admitted his temper got the best of him when he unleashed a tirade on several boys he claims were bullying his 12-year-old daughter who had cerebral palsy.
I'm gonna show me which one. Yeah, you call the police. Call the police.
In an appearance on NBC's Today Show, his daughter, 12-year-old Shatari Jones, broke her silence on what these bullies put her through.
Were you afraid that it was just going to get worse and worse?
Yeah.
What kinds of things were they doing to you on that bus?
They were poking me with pencils, called me outside my name, spitting in my hair, and condoms were getting thrown on the bus.
The National Center for Education Statistics say 25% of all students are bullied, but among kids with disabilities, 85% are targeted.
My action was very much out of line, out of character for me. But my daughter, I still love her and I support her.
Australia. A recently released video has caused outrage over the use of taser guns. The video, released by the West Australian Corruption and Crime Commission, shows two policemen as they stun an inebriated man 8 times. Other officers, seen observing the incident, do not react to the unprovoked attack, which included an additional 5 taser strikes off camera. Tasers are only permitted to be used by members of the Australian Police Force in situations of danger or serious injury. The two officers in question have been fined for their unjust use of the tasers. And that's a look on the international front. And now, sports and entertainment. Rick Ross is the latest artist to have objects thrown at him on stage during a performance. Waka Flocka barely missed being pounded with bottles during a May performance, while French Montana was pelted with ice in August. Now Ross can add his name to the list of rappers under attack after performing at New York's Mid-Hudson Civic Center. Footage captured the incident showing a female fan suddenly rushing the stage before being escorted off by security. Following that, Ross continued performing as usual before a bottle was thrown from the crowd that nearly struck him in the head. Take another look. The bottle flies out of the crowd and barely misses the Teflon Don. And now, on this day in Black history, novelist and professor Toni Morrison became the first African-American woman to be awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature. Morrison began writing fiction as part of an informal group of poets and writers at Howard University. Her novels are known for their epic themes, vivid dialogue, and richly detailed Black characters. Among her best-known works are The Bluest Eye, Song of Solomon, and Beloved, which won the American Book Award and the Pulitzer Prize for Fiction in 1988, a precursor to winning the Nobel Prize on this date in 1993. Well, that's it for us here at Black TV 24/7 News. For more information on the stories covered during this newscast, please visit us at blacktv247news.com and click on the story links. Until tomorrow, I'm Aaron Elkins. Have a financially rewarding Thursday. And remember, you can catch us online 24/7.